Let's talk about the Fermi Paradox. Wait a minute, Mr. Stickman, that's not a question. Your videos always start with a question. Yeah, okay, calm down, I know. I'm trying something new. Besides, the Fermi Paradox is a question in itself. It's fairly simple, but man, it's one of my favorite questions that I've ever heard be asked. It goes as follows. Given the massive scale of the universe and the fact that sheer probability seems to suggest that life would be very common, then where are all the aliens? I'll break down that question in a little bit, but first, let me briefly explain this choice of topic. Little known fact, I really love space. It's one of my main interests. I've been thinking about aliens for a very long time, since I was just a wee little stick boy. I've done a few videos on space in the past, but nothing like this one. I hope if this isn't something you'd usually be interested in, you'll stick around and learn something new. So anyways, back to the Fermi Paradox. When did it first come about? What kind of research about the topic has been conducted since? And of course, most importantly, what's the answer to it? Let's dive in and try to figure out where all the aliens may be. The origins of the Fermi Paradox are pretty random. In 1950, physicist Enrico Fermi, yes, that's who this whole thing is named after, was having lunch with a few colleagues. At this lunch, when discussing the possibility of whether or not there are other intelligent civilizations out there in our galaxy and the rest of the universe, Fermi asked the question I already stated, where are all the aliens? After this lunch, he thought about it more and realized he might be onto something. Since that point, the Fermi Paradox has baffled researchers, scientists, and everyday people alike. So now let's get into the basics of it. A lot of people have thought about this question, and one of the first things they note about the Fermi Paradox is that it's an extremely strong argument. Here's why. When Fermi first began exploring answers to his paradox, he hypothesized that any civilization with a modest amount of rocket technology and a decent amount of incentive could rapidly colonize the Milky Way, the galaxy we humans call home. Within a few tens of millions of years, an advanced alien civilization like that could, in theory, colonize most of the galaxy. That may seem like a really long time, but it's very short compared to the age of the Milky Way, which is roughly 1,000 times older. Basically, Fermi came to the conclusion that aliens have had more than enough time to get around the galaxy if they actually exist. But how can we be so sure that aliens are actually there in the first place? Well, we can't know with absolute certainty, but as I mentioned previously, probability suggests that they are. Let's take the Drake equation, for example. I've discussed this in a previous video, but to summarize what this horrible thing is that you're seeing on screen right now, it's an equation that was created by astrophysicist Frank Drake to estimate the potential number of advanced civilizations in the Milky Way galaxy. You don't need to know what all the variables represent, but if you want to read more about this, my sources are in the description. What the Drake equation concludes, though, is that the only way humans are the only advanced civilization in the Milky Way is if the odds of a civilization developing on a habitable planet are less than about 1 in 10 billion trillion. In other words, the odds of civilization developing in the Milky Way need to be unbelievably low for humans to be the only advanced life in the galaxy. So that's how probability suggests that we're not alone. Why does that matter though? Well, it only strengthens the Fermi Paradox's argument. Like I said earlier, many people have struggled to figure this out. You can mess with many variables, like the speed at which an alien civilization could hypothetically colonize the galaxy, but that doesn't matter and ultimately doesn't change the answer. As the SETI Institute puts it, quote, it's like discussing whether Spanish ships of the 16th century could heave along at 2 knots or 20. Either way, they could speedily colonize the Americas. Okay, now you know the problem, but what's the solution? There are many theories, so I now want to take you through a few of my favorites. Let's jump in. The first solution to the Fermi Paradox that I'm talking about today is the Great Filter Theory. To be clear here, when I say filter in this context, I'm talking about a barrier or obstacle that's really difficult to overcome. To be even more specific, we're talking about barriers that are extremely hard for life in our universe to overcome. The idea behind this theory is that when life reaches a filter, it either gets through it and survives or goes extinct. That's how difficult these filters are to get through. Overall, the key here is that there is something that exists in the universe that makes becoming a galactic civilization almost impossible. The issue, though, is that we don't know where that filter lies. It could be behind us in terms of human development as a civilization, or it could be ahead of us. Let's start with what great filters may lie behind us. It could be that life in general is very rare in the Milky Way and in the rest of the universe. Maybe the building blocks of life need such perfect conditions that it hardly ever springs up, even on the most habitable planets. Or maybe something like basic life is extremely common, but the development of advanced brains and higher intelligence is a filter that very little life gets by. On the other side of things, it's possible that the great filter still lies in front of us. Maybe all life in the universe encounters irreversible climate change before they can escape their home planet. Perhaps nuclear war is what does all life in. Or it could be that all life is destined to create artificial intelligence, which then becomes so intelligent that it destroys most of the life that creates it. There might even be some technology that we haven't even discovered yet that could be the great filter. I know I'm getting philosophical here, but that's just the main idea behind the great filter theory. And it does a decent job at answering the Fermi paradox. If we were to one day find bacterial life on Mars, that wouldn't be ideal. Finding intelligent life would also be bad. The more common life is in the universe, the more likely it is that the great filter is still in front of us humans, which means we might inevitably be doomed. That's the great filter theory summed up. Isn't that super cheery? Unfortunately, not many answers to the Fermi paradox are very fun. I will say that this next one is a bit less anxiety-inducing though. Let's get into that. Despite how primitive we are on the grand scale of the universe, humans haven't exactly been completely quiet about our location in the Milky Way. We've routinely sent out radio signals across our area in the galaxy, and while they haven't traveled super far, in fact they haven't really traveled far at all, but that's besides the point, it's still possible that these radio signals have drawn some attention. This is kind of where the zoo hypothesis comes into play. Maybe the aliens out there know we're here, but they don't want to interact with us. But why wouldn't they? Well, it could be for a variety of reasons. Perhaps they're observing us for scientific research. Or maybe it's because they don't want to interfere with our natural evolution. It could even be because they just don't think interacting with us would be worth their time. It's that final point that I want to touch on a bit more. If you were a part of a spacefaring galactic civilization, would you really want to stop and interact with life that hasn't even left its home planet yet? I don't know if they would. They would probably view humans like how we view ants. Sure, we build cool structures, but they could very easily step on us and kill us if they want to. Anyways, that's the basis of the zoo hypothesis. And it does a decent job at answering the Fermi paradox. However, it does begin to fall apart a little bit when you think about the reasoning behind it. Why would aliens find us special, especially if life in the galaxy is so plentiful? Additionally, how likely is it that multiple advanced alien civilizations would come to an agreement to randomly isolate humans for something like scientific study? Because of that logic, it makes the zoo hypothesis seem a bit too self-centered and far-fetched to truly be considered as an answer to the Fermi paradox. Regardless, it's still very fun to think about. Now let's move to the third and final solution I have for you. Hate to tell you, but it's the darkest and scariest of them all. Here we go. The dark forest hypothesis is honestly a genuinely scary thought. I don't like it, though at the same time it really intrigues me. But what is it? Well, imagine the universe is just that, a dark forest. In that forest, humanity, as well as every other form of life that may exist in our galaxy and beyond, are the hunters. The hunters don't want to become the hunted. By that logic, the dark forest hypothesis argues that the intentions of any newly contacted civilization can never be known. This means that if one is encountered, it is best to shoot first and ask questions later to avoid the destruction of one's own species. It's a chilling thought, but this would explain why every advanced civilization has decided to keep quiet, because they're fearful of their own demise. Anyone who is bold enough to reach out is destroyed by others who are afraid of what their intentions may be. Basically, it's possible that the universe is an extremely hostile place for all involved. If this hypothesis holds true, then humanity may already be in trouble. As I mentioned earlier, we've already done some outreach into the stars. We haven't heard back yet, but if the dark forest hypothesis is correct, then maybe some advanced alien civilization that heard our messages is already on the way to take us out as you watch this video. I'm not saying that's likely though. Like I said, this is just one of the many, many solutions to the Fermi paradox. I do find it extremely intriguing to think about the universe in this way though. I sure hope it's not this hostile, otherwise we may be in for a very rude awakening. While the three solutions I just went over are my favorites for trying to answer the Fermi paradox, there are a ton more theories that attempt to explain it. Unfortunately, I couldn't cover all of them, but if you think there's one explanation that I really should have talked about, let me know down below. One more possibility I should mention, maybe we're alone. It would be pretty sad if we were the only life in this absurdly massive empty space, but it's not entirely out of the realm of possibility. I choose to believe that we're not, but the chance that we are is still above zero. The Fermi paradox is one of astronomy's many great mysteries. It's a great reminder that, despite how far we humans have come, we still have a very long way to go when it comes to understanding the world and the universe around us. So let's all be nice to each other and work together, okay? I think that's a good way to end this. That's all I've got for this hypothetical. If you enjoyed it, please feel free to like and subscribe. More videos coming soon. If you've got ideas for a video you want to see, feel free to comment them down below. I'm always looking for new content. If I pick your idea, I'll shout you out, I promise. As a reminder, all of my sources for this video are in the description down below. Feel free to check them out if you're interested. Thanks so much for all of your recent support. I really appreciate it. Hope I see you next time.